So we are back into the modeling that we've been up to. So it's been some substantial progress so far. So as I was thinking that probably the best way to continue about this would be simply to just introduce each elements like windows and doors and get them all into everywhere that they have to go. Before we get there, let me first fix this these columns here. So I'm gonna hide this one for now. Best way that I'm thinking to get this column. Because these columns currently are the clone of go to selection. They're the clone of this column, and so that means that they don't belong to the same family, because they're gonna be much shorter. They're gonna be about this tall. So we need a new set of columns. So what I'm gonna do is probably create another one of these. I'm just copy this one, copy and paste. So this one, that, and this one, I'll simply delete them. And so the new column, put my snap right there, put my plane, my working plane, and then select that column, select that, and simply grab it from this node, from this corner, and simply move him right here. I can change the height, so it's gonna be this height, which is 2 meters. Select that and just put 2 meters right there and clone that 2 times. Select both clones and move one. Right here. And so currently I see it's a different column size that used to go there, so I may have to just delete that. Select that, make a copy. Copy. Paste. And this one goes here. It's gonna have a width of 2.5. Like so, and so just place him where it belongs. Like that. And so this will be renamed that. And so two. Okay. And then now I can clone that. And move that clone right there. So now I can put my plane here, select that plane, and put my working plane there. And all I have to do now is well, actually, select this face, measure this entire thing. So I'm gonna select that, copy that, copy, paste, select that, give it a height of 0.35. And then move him. About right here. And tell it to have a width of 605. 6.05. So like that. And just move him. As simple as that. Okay. Put my working plane back on the ground, and so we have something that we can seemingly begin to work with. Okay, so where are we? I'm gonna put a working section and my building. So inside my building, floor plan 1. Okay, the slabs. And then floor 2. Okay. So I'm gonna put that inside the building. Inside the building. The slabs as well. What are these lines again? Select that. Okay, those were my initial guides. I probably don't need you to delete that. Just sweeping and cleaning up things. I probably don't need you anymore, so we'll put you in the store. This as well. Stored. I can just delete them, but maybe I could need them, so I just think it'd be good to store them for now. What about you? Okay. I don't think I need these. Okay, this array, I need that. Store that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create structure inside my building. I should have had a folder with structure already. I don't create a folder. rename that structure. Well, basically what I'm trying to say is concrete features, you know, cast concrete rather, because structure can also be the brick walls and stuff like that. So we'll go back to shaded. Now select that. In the structure, in the cast concrete, okay, so this column as well needs to be a beam. Rename that 6.05. By that, by 2.35 m, enter. It's a beam. Put that there. A separate folder for the walls inside my building, floor plan 1 walls. Okay, so I already have that walls going here, floor plan 1. I don't need this wall anymore. Okay, so which one? My newly created wall. This goes in floor plan 1 as well. Okay, so what else? The doors are not hiding. Delete this wall. Wall 102. No, who is that? Wall 102. Okay. So they're linked. I don't understand why the window, the door is not gonna hide along with the wall. Anyways, strange behavior. Moving on. So now that I have, who's that? Okay, so that rename. For now, beam. Beam. Oh no, this is a bit warm. This would be wood wall. Put the beam in inside the cast structure, and this I put them on level 2, floor level 2 walls. Okay, that's my building. So what do we have in our building? Okay, so we have this. It's in the cast, okay. Concrete cast. Okay. And we have our windows and windows walls, okay. So I'm gonna put the cast. Inside. The building. I'm gonna put these windows walls inside the building as well. And this will go so the cast. Ring beam. I don't think you should be in the store. I'll delete you. Needed. Delete. And all these dimensions, delete. Okay, so my building is clean. My structure is clean. So I have the building now. And that's all the building. So now what I can do is my top plane is activated. So I'm going to put a section plane right here and then scale it. Like this, display height. Okay, there you go. So I'm going to place you position in the Y like this, and view in the display land. Scroll that like that. Little bit more, and then here I'm going to go with the X direction like this. Go to the front. From the Z, I'm going to put it at 1.5. meters above the ground. It's a nine cutting plane level. Just slightly increase the edge. That will be here. Arrow size. We're going to go with 100 or 1000. Or 1 meter will be fine. Previous section going on here. It was this longitudinal section. Okay. So let's take this section and call it floor plan. Rename that section floor plan level 1. I wonder what happens if I copy and paste. Hide this. Okay. Call that floor plan level 2. Rename. Okay, well, whatever. So this is gonna go up to a height of 4.5, I think. Would be good. 4.5. Okay. And then paste another one. This is gonna be 4.level 3. Sections folder, so everything is organized nicely. So now select the building and then control select the section and add the building into this section. So now I can select this section and I can tell it cut view through. So now I can see from the top what's going on, and I can select this section. I can generate a shape 2D, and this is gonna take a little bit of time. Here's my shape 2D. In my shape 2D, I come to the data and I tell my shape 2D to be a projection. I want it to be cut faces right there, so everything's full. So what I can do, to reset this a little bit. Okay, so this works now. Okay, so now I can hide this. So let me work on this internal wall. I'm gonna hide this floor because it's annoying for now. Make sure I'm still on the top lane. So I'm gonna draw a wall here. Select my line. And the thing that's interesting about this wall is the way it connects here, so I'm not exactly sure. I have to really look into the details of what's going on here. But for now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to draw a wall here to represent that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use one of these lines to justify. So I want to select that section, then it falls, and I want to select this other section. Actually, I want to know how tall this is. Goes all the way to the ceiling. Let me select that face and measure that very quickly. This is gonna be so. we're going to select the same line and drop two more walls, and these walls are each going to be 2.25 tall, but they will also be 10 mil 0.1. So now I'm going to offset this one to the right like this, and I'm going to offset align this one to the right, to the left like so, and then I am going to offset it 0.4. So these two walls I'm just gonna give them a gentle color to make it recognizable. Transparency value maybe. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select that section and cut view control. Select the new clear walls I just made. Well, I have to do the same thing here. This wall, should I select this other line? Create three walls, select it again, two more, and another one. And I select that, that. Height 2.25. Okay, and this one has a width of 50. So let's align this one. That's a little right, that's good. That's the 0.4 guy. Let's hide that for now. Hide this for now. Let's look at this one. Okay, so let me align you right. Okay, good, you're fine. Hide that. Bring you, align that to the left like this, okay, and then offset that by 0.4. That's good. And then bring this one on and then align that to the left. Perfect. So now we have all the walls there. So now I can simply select all these walls. Add them to building level 1 walls. Like that. Okay. So it will take jolting the placement of this. That so that it will update, recompute. Okay. So we have everything looking good. So now it's time to place our doors. So we need some 2 doors here. So let me see what are the dimensions of this door. So what I will do in that instance is I will select this door, go to selection, where are you, and I'll copy this door, see what kind of door it is. Selected objects have independence. Is there a selected object you want to copy them to? Yes. Okay. Paste. Select the sketch. Then grab the sketch from this corner. Sketch, zoom into the sketch. Select that and move that here. Now I can enter this. Perspective, change that to 07. It's not exactly the same thing, but sketch. You want the graphic. Okay, so I have to bring back my complete true false. Going this back. Fucking modifications here. does not have these things. This is the wire that has an issue, I think. Is it? Nope. I think it's the fact that it has a glass. This glass, door glass, let's remove that. Close. Edit. Edit. Okay, so that this one is based on wired 01 and 02 when it's supposed to just be based on this wire. Close that. Okay, perfect. Now we have our door. It's looking neat. Now let's bring back our wall that we hid and select this door and then select the wall and add the door. Perfect. Perfecto. Perfecto. So now bring back this cut view true. Select this door. Now clone that door. Clone the door and select this door. Now grab it from here. Press shift to lock it on that axis. And snap it right here. Now select this, select the wall, the door, and then select the wall by pressing control and press the plus button, and there you go. It's just that it seems to lose its materiality. Okay, so that's that for that. Okay, so let's bring this back up. Actually, maybe not yet. Let's jolt back this. So what do I have here? It Select that face. Five point 48. So I'm gonna assume that this is once again 60. They don't offset of about 25 off the edge so that it compensates for the corrugation of the metal panel that's gonna go on the side. So what I'm gonna do is simply I'm going to draw a line here I hope I'm touching the edge okay right there. There's the same instance right here as well. I know I could be using the feature where you can that I showed you on one of the tutorial where you can use one sketch line to generate all these walls, but because I'm trying to understand a few of these things, I have to do things in a bit in a diligent way. You know, of course, once I figure out everything, it will be a bit more interesting to see now how I can just replace these things with one line. But for now, since I tested it last time, it didn't exactly work. For the sake of time and for, you know, making progress and understanding the drawing itself, I cannot exactly spend so much time on that aspect itself. So on trying to make sure the lines to work, I'm making sure my text-to-speech node is working. Okay, so where else do we have an instance similar? I think right here again. So I'm gonna just draw a line right here. Right here as well. So generate walls. Gonna bring this back. View perspective. I think that my new wall have to be 2 meters tall. Two. And I think that they should be 60.06. Okay, so let's go back there and perspective. This one will be right justified. It's looking good. We will look at translating these future installations last. Well, let me look at the second floor. Bit. So I'm going to select the second floor plane. Let me hide this one. Bring that here. Select the second floor as well, and I want to select the entire building and then put that inside the section as well. And I'm going to generate two copies, one two and maybe three copies. So the first one, I'm going to make it projection cut faces. Select this and tell it to be true. Okay. View perspective. And just like the other one, just change the color. And hide that. Now for the two other copies, I'm just gonna move them on the side, so make sure you're on the floor, top plane, and top view, orthographic, select those, actually select one line, drop it like that, and then select this, and then move them here. It's lagging a little bit. Select that and that. Select that and that. Why is my snap not working? It's lagging from so okay, so now I can compare a few things here. This is looking good. Windows looking good. Columns in place. This feature is there. Okay, so I need a door here. How wide is this door? .79. I'm guessing this is 0.8. Okay. I have this wall that I need to put in. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm actually gonna trace these walls over. Something is a bit strange with my snaps. It's not letting me snap. Select that. Actually, I don't need to do that. select this, I'm gonna make a copy, go to selection, copy, and paste. Select this copy, and select him. And change that to auto. Select this. And move that here. Where did you go? Select this face, maybe. Try this way. Select that scale. The music is driving me nuts, man. Much better. Top view. I'm going to hide this. But I have a new problem which shows me what's at the base. There was a new feature that Yuri came up with that's supposed to allow you to check out or give you some degree of control over the way you view the floors. working plain proxy, so let's go to create work plane proxy. Okay. So where's my work plane proxy? Display size. Okay. That's gonna be you. Okay, so what I want to do now, if I right click that, I can see write object state. Okay, so in this case what I want to do is I want to hide this building, hide all the level one. I want to hide this. This. We are testing this new feature. I've never used it myself. Okay. And you, we are going to make you true. So now I'm going to select this working plane and write object state. Okay. Now I'm bring back the entire building and let's see what happens. I'm not sure how you bring it back. All right, well, whatever. Basically, I have to move on. So maybe you go to selection and where it says toggle selectability. Show selection. Toggle selectability, no. So now I cannot select it. So if I go to top view, I can certainly draw on top of it without it highlighting or moving around. Let's hope so. So I wanted to draw a line here. I'm not exactly sure why my snaps are not showing up anymore. So let me save this. Close that and bring it back up. Okay. No, that's not what it is. I don't need this. Finally. Okay, so let's try that again. Architecture. Grab my stuff. And my snaps are still not showing. What is going on with my snaps? Make that circle selectability, no. Okay, so now I can't select that. See, now I can't tell if it's snapping at that end. That's what I'm looking for, those little white dots. The white dot disappeared again. Boy, this is definitely not my cup of tea day, you know? Okay, let's see if we can work this way. Select that line, stretch it all the way to the snaps on this edge. Select that, stretch it here. Okay, like that. Millimeters warm. Millimeter wall. Okay. So I have this line. This line will be the 80 millimeter wall. So select that data width 0.8 and tell it to be right justified. No, left. Perfect. This would be 70. So 07. This would be right. And this would be right as well. Okay. Okay, so go back to level 2. So how tall are those walls supposed to be? gonna guess 2 meters for now. This line is not supposed to stretch all the way in there. Of course, this is a future addition. I was trying to make sense out of it. I was like, well, something's not exactly right. But yeah, that's a future addition. So this wall is for, it's gonna be for another time. We create a folder here. Future. Okay, so this is my what door size is this? 0.8. So let's bring back our entire building, and of course my doors are not gonna show up. Go to selection. And copy this door. Copy. Yes. Paste. Select that instead. Now make sure I'm on that face. Go to the front. View perspective. Select that sketch. Sketch right here. Now select this plane. Building slabs level 2. Make selectable. Toggle selectability, select that, put my plane on there. Maybe I don't want to select you again. Now select my sketch, simply rotate that. 90 degrees. Where's my dog? Okay, maybe it's because of the offset here that the door is not moving along with. Scrap this door, not useful. Don't know what I'm gonna do with that. If I cannot play with it, let me try this wall and its door. Go to selection, select this door, rather, its sketch. On this plane, select that sketch and then just drag it somewhere along here. Is that my copy? No. Select that, copy, good selection, copy, yes, and come here and paste. Now I can select that sketch and move that. Hide the door. Select that, put the working plane there, and then hide that again. So now select this sketch. sketch. And move that. Right here. And then I'm going to travel to the come on, though, are you going to rotate as well? Let me see if it's a question of people playing. Oh, something strangely broken. Perhaps I have to select both of them. Interesting. Oh boy. Lots of strange results. Well, maybe I should just draw a new door. Make life a little bit easier. Select that face, put my plane there, and bring me a door, window. A simple door. Okay. So this will have a height of 2. Bring out the sketch. Mm-hmm. every cat just crushed on me. Great news. Drop this section here as well. Select this face, drop the plane there, and put your section there. And take my building and bring inside this section. Add, select this section and bring him forward in the X. Projection faces and change the color. Okay, I can hide if you want. Faces deselected, so now I can drop it here. It's gonna be easy. File save. Sketch. Select the sketch. My dome has to be 0.8 meters wide. Sketch again, just position that again. Okay.
7 mana. Okay, that's perfect. So now on the door itself. Out of frame, edit, there is zero offset here, and this thickness, let's update that. And the door, the offset will be zero as well. So there we go, we have a door. So select this door, copy, yes, and paste. Now here, select the sketch, bring that sketch out. I'm gonna grab it from this corner. Sketch out. Select that. Okay, so now hide that sketch. I can select this door. Because it has to think about its sections all the time now. Let me hide that first.
it for now. Okay, so what else are we missing? I think that this door is in, this door is in, and this door is in. These are the future doors. What else are we missing? Currently I'm at 6.6 gigabytes, so what I'm gonna do now is convert this to a panel like this. A wavelength high and a wavelength length. Probably a wavelength length of. I'll just check from here. Top view. So I have a wave height of 25 millimeters. of 76 millimeters. So select my panel. Width length 76 millimeter. See what happens. Oh, it did work. Okay, so I've got something. It's giving me the same results. Probably not enough for that. So what I'm gonna do is bring back this other guy and change the rotation. To have about a value of 12 millimeters or 13 millimeters. Okay, so let me bring the panel back. Sixteen. 16 millimeters. Those waves are a little bit strange. Maybe reduce the wave height a little bit. That would be here. Let's go with 50. Oops. Oh my god. Wavelength. So I have to go higher. So let's say 90. See what happens. Okay guys, so I think I'm gonna stop here for this. It's pretty good level and I'm gonna continue on later on. So that's that for now, and I hope I'll see you in the next tutorial.